Hello, in today's lesson we are going to speak about teaching pronunciation, and we have a big question. Why teach pronunciation? Why do we need it? There are two main reasons why we need to teach pronunciation, why we need to include element of teaching pronunciation in our foreign language teaching classes. So first of all, it's obvious that a speaker who constantly mispronounces some words or range of phonemes is difficult to be understood. And the next main reason is growth of English. Due to the increased role of English as the most important, one of the most important languages in the world, so many people want to speak this language, and all people may have non-native speakers may have different accents and different way to pronounce. So that's why we need to achieve understandable pronunciation and include this element of pronunciation in our foreign teaching language classes. Well, and consequently appears another question: what pronunciation model to teach? You know that nowadays, due to globalization, so many people are exposed to English, exposed to different varieties of English. Well, it's due to increased international travel or development of online learning. Well, and also because of popularity of English, English becomes like serves as lingua franca. It means that many non-native speakers use English as a language of intercommunication. Well, so for a successful mastering of pronunciation, students should have access to different accents and language variations. And also, because majority of teachers are not always native speakers, that's why we need to be exposed to different accents. And as a result, we have so-called received pronunciation. Well, what it means? Received pronunciation is understandable. It should be correct pronunciation of sounds in of phonemes in order to be understood by all speakers, native and non-native speakers of English. Well, and teaching pronunciation is also a controversial aspect of teaching in general. Why? Because in some classes, teachers don't pay due attention to teaching pronunciation. They may give more emphasis on teaching grammar or teaching vocabulary. And also, it depends on the teaching pronunciation also may depend on goal. The main goal of all teaching in general is achieve accent-free speech, but being optimistic, we know that it's quite difficult to achieve, not impossible, but quite difficult to achieve. Well, and we have to establish goals according to students' level, at the beginning level and advanced level. So at the beginning level, the main goal is for students to achieve understandable, clear and correct pronunciation of sounds, of English sounds. And at the advanced level, the main goal would be for students to achieve correct intonation and some suprasegmental elements of pronunciation like pitch, tone, stress, etc. Well, and also we need to teach pronunciation because it constitutes the main element and the main important point as necessary link between speaking and listening comprehension. Because if you do not understand what speaker is saying, it's because you do not know how sounds are pronounced, your communication won't be successful too. And if you cannot produce correct speech, also your communication will be disrupted. Exist different approaches in pronunciation teaching. So during much time, pronunciation has been given a secondary role in language teaching. Majority of teachers were worried about teaching correct grammar or increasing vocabulary amount. Even nowadays, some teachers may say that no, pronunciation is not necessary. What is necessary for students is to construct correctly, syntactically correct sentences, or to manage or to have a big store of vocabulary in order to communicate. But due to, again, I repeat again, due to globalization, that many people want to communicate in English, so pronunciation receives more importance and should be included in teaching pronunciation during class. Well, and the main approach that exists in teaching pronunciation is from reactive to planned teaching. What it means? Reactive refers to this situation that, for example, students constantly mispronounce or make the same mistakes in a pronunciation of certain sounds, so a teacher has to react to this somehow and thus giving a model or teaching how these difficult sounds should be pronounced. Or another approach is planned teaching, when teachers consciously prepare or design class in such a way when elements of teaching pronunciation are included, are analyzed, and are practiced. So pronunciation practice should be like this. It should be included elements of teaching vocabulary and particular language structure. So when teachers present a new grammar or language structure, also they have to emphasize the correct pronunciation and ways how to correctly pronounce difficult sounds that are different from students' native language sounds. Well, and so let us analyze so-called planned teaching pronunciation. And this planned teaching pronunciation is constituted by three main kinds of classes or lessons. So first is integrated lesson, when teacher can work on the following aspects of pronunciation, like vowel sounds, emphasize how vowel sounds should be pronounced, how they are produced, what is the difference between, for example, Spanish vowel system and English sound system. Well, and also include elements, teaching diphthongs, triphthongs, etc., and consonants, the main difference between, for example, Spanish and English consonants, the way they are produced and they are pronounced. You know that in Spanish language there are some sounds that are not existing, that do not exist in English, and vice versa. Well, and also include elements of stress, word stress, sentence stress, and forms. And next next kind of lessons is so-called remedial lesson. Remedial, when teacher sees that the most persistent mistakes that students produce, so a teacher says, okay, something should be done. We need to apply some remedies. Well, and so these classes are focused on specific troublesome sounds. Well, so here you see the teacher should use activities which deal with pronunciation difficulties. So remedial classes, they are very, very specific lessons. Very specific lessons and activities are designed around the most difficult or troublesome sounds. Well, and here the main technique can be used like minimal pair contrast of sounds. Some sounds can be presented in pairs like you have here, for example, hot and hat, sock, sack, etc. Or it's an example of consonants or vowels, and examples of consonants with can be very difficult for some speakers, like b sound and w or b sound. Well, especially the sounds are confused by majority of Spanish speakers. So like in words beep or vip, yeah, they may be pronounced in the same way, which will lead to misunderstanding when speaking with the native speakers. So if you present these words in minimal pairs, like minimal pairs, they have just one sound that has a difference. Well, so it will help students to understand the difference, and teacher has to explain how the sounds are produced. Well, And here are some more very general techniques. Students may listen and repeat the sounds during remedial lessons, or listen and circle a certain sound. Teacher may read or play a CD with the sounds, and students have to listen and identify or underline a concrete sound. Or also the useful technique is work with the dictionary to find words with a concrete or a certain sound for students to be sure how the sounds are pronounced. And then when we start practicing, we may include these words with troublesome sounds in dialogues or role plays. And the third kind of lesson is so-called practice lesson. Well, practice lesson, it's very challenging and very important, and it gives a chance to both students to practice concrete sounds and for teachers to give students this chance to practice and see and analyze where sounds are produced correctly or which sounds are still cause some difficulties for students, what needs to be improved and practiced more. So these practice lessons basically consist of three very clearly defined phases. First is presentation. Well, during presentation, teacher presents a new sound, and the main point here for students to produce these sounds very correctly and be able to recognize and discriminate this sound. So main emphasis or focus is on accuracy. Accuracy means very accurate pronunciation of concrete sound. Next phase is practice. Well, practice students when they understand the production, how the sounds are produced, how they are pronounced. So next phase, they have to practice. So we combine accuracy, very accurate pronunciation of some sounds, and we have to include some elements of fluency when students have to try to pronounce new sounds in a more natural way. Well, and so teacher here has to control, check the understanding, monitor and correct if it's necessary, if there are some difficulties in pronunciation of sounds. Well, and students can repeat individually or chorally, which is a very useful technique to pronounce sounds in chorus when students have no fear in producing new sounds. Well, and then students may use technique called chain, back chain, or drilling technique in produce correct language. And the last phase is production. Well, production, it's a free stage when students are expected to produce in natural form words containing these sounds. Well, and here we combine elements of fluency and accuracy also should be presented. And teacher simply observes and manages the process, no correction here. All corrections should be done during practice phase. And I would like to give more explanations about practice. So fluency and accuracy, and what is the difference between them? Well, so in accuracy, students are expected to achieve very, very correct production of sounds, and accuracy allows students to focus on elements on phonology or grammar and discourse. It's not this technique or this notion as accuracy can be applied not only in production of correct sounds, but it also can be used when we want to achieve correct production of grammar, sentences and discourse elements. Well, and fluency, well, it's initial goal of all language teaching. We want our students to be fluent. Well, but we also want them to be correct in production of language. Well, so like a summary, I want to emphasize that accuracy, learners should know that they are repeating new items, and students need to know that they are expected to avoid mistakes. Well, and fluency, so is intended to get learners to use new items in more natural communication, and fluency in during this stage, teacher has to call students' attention on communication itself. So students are not expected to think about grammar structure, but on fluency. Well, it is all what I wanted to speak with you in this lesson. Thank you very much.